All right. Good morning. Thank you for joining us for our Safer at Home series. This is Storytime in Color. Okay, good. So today we are going to have a special guest reader. Her name is Nia Devine. She is going to come on in a couple minutes. I'm going to start off by reading a book just to get us warmed up and allow some more people to join us. And then I will be introducing our guest reader, and she'll join the chat, and she'll be reading a special book for you. So the opening book that I'm going to be doing is called Baby Goes to Market by Atinuke, and it's illustrated by Angela Brooksbank. So, Baby Goes to Market. Baby goes to market with Mama. Market is very crowded. Baby is very curious. Baby is so curious that Mrs. Ade, the banana seller, gives baby 6 bananas. Baby is so surprised, baby eats 1 banana. And puts 5 bananas in the basket. Mama does not notice. She is busy buying rice. Market is very crowded. Baby is very hot. Baby is so hot that Mr. Femi, the orange seller, gives baby 5 juicy oranges. Baby grins. Baby sucks 1 orange and puts 4 oranges in the basket. Mama does not notice. She is busy buying homemade palm oil. Market is very crowded. Baby is very cheerful. Baby is so cheerful that Mr. Momo, the biscuit seller, gives baby 4 sugary chin chin biscuits. Baby claps. Baby eats 1 chin chin and puts 3 chin chin in the basket. Mama does not notice. She is busy buying chili peppers. Market is very crowded. Baby is very funny. Baby is so funny that Mrs. Kunle, sweet corn seller, gives baby 3 roasted sweet corn. Baby beams. Baby eats 1 roasted sweet corn and puts 2 roasted sweet corn in the basket. Mama does not notice. She is busy buying flip-flops. Market is very crowded. Baby is very naughty. Very naughty, pulling on all the clothes. Baby is so sorry that Mrs. Dele, the coconut seller, gives baby 2 pieces of coconut. Baby licks his lips. Baby eats 1 piece of coconut and puts the other piece of coconut in the basket. Mama does not notice. Her basket is very heavy. Very, very heavy. And Mama thinks her sweet baby must be hungry by now. Taxi, Mama shouts. We need to get home quick and fast. Mama puts her baskets down. What's this? Cried Mama. 5 bananas, 4 oranges, 3 chin chin biscuits, 2 roasted sweet corn, 1 piece of coconut. I did not buy these. No, you didn't, cries Mrs. Ade, the banana seller, and Mr. Femi, the orange seller, and Mr. Momo, the chin chin seller, and Mrs. Kunle, the sweet corn seller, and Mrs. Dele, the coconut seller. We gave those to the baby. Mama looked at baby. Baby laughs. Mama laughs too. What a good baby, she says. You put all those things straight into the basket. Mama rides the taxi. Baby goes to sleep. Poor baby, says Mama. He's not had one single thing to eat. So as you can see, this baby ate himself to sleep, and the mother had no clue he was eating. She thought he put all of those snacks inside the basket. And this was Baby Goes to Market by Atinuke and Angela Brooksbank for the illustration. So I hope you all enjoyed this book. I actually borrowed the books that I am reading today from my godson, Shakur. I think he'll be tuning in a little bit later. I don't know, Mr. Barber, much about this author. However, these books were purchased. One of our classmates from Miami Northwestern, she has an organization called Splash on Literacy. And she also does these book box subscription sets that feature books that have characters of color and different cultural backgrounds, so that it can, you know, children of all different cultural backgrounds can relate to the characters in the children's books. So that's where this book came from, and the book that we're going to be reading next. Our special guest is Miss Nia Devine. She is a songstress, a lyricist, a songwriter. She also works with the Black Archives with our audio visuals. So she is a woman of many talents, and she loves doing outreach like this, reading to children. So I'm going to be adding her to the chat as soon as I see her request. Let me see. Alrighty. All right. Welcome, Nia. How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great. Good, all right. Good. Can everybody hear Nia good?
Can you guys hear me?
You sound good on my end.
Yeah, because I'm kind of soft-spoken.
Okay. All right, Nia. So this book that you're reading is Every Little Thing. It is written by Cedella Marley, which is an adaptation of Bob Marley's very popular song, Three Little Birds. And this song, this book has a part from the song that I know would be much better received from a lovely songstress as yourself. So I called in for reinforcements, and I thank you for joining us today. So you can go ahead and greet everybody and get started when you're ready.
Well, thank you for having me. Hi, everyone. She just said, I am a singer-songwriter. I'm from Miami. Right now, I have a couple of projects out that you guys can check out after I read the story here. I have a single out called Games. You can click the link that's in my bio on my IG page to get to it. But let's go ahead and get to the story. Every Little Thing it's based on the story of Three Little Birds by Bob Marley. And here we are. Rise up this morning, smile with the rising sun. Can everyone see a sun?
Can you put the book a little bit closer to the camera?
Yeah, it's this good?
Up a little. There you go.
Got it now? Yeah. So rise up this morning, smile with the rising sun. Can you guys see a sun in the picture? Right there. And are you able to spot another sun? Over there in the corner. Three little birds pitch by my doorstep, singing sweet songs of melodies pure and true, saying, this is my message to you. Does everyone see the three birds? Can you count the three birds? One, two, three. Don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing is gonna be all right. Run to the playground, laugh with my friends and play. Three little birds perch on the swing set. Listening these words, these harmonies sweet in the air. Sometimes you just need to show you care. And you say, don't worry about a thing. Every little thing is gonna be all right. See those three birds again? Help in the kitchen, stirring up delicious fun. Three little birds fly by my window, chirping out loud. They're reminding us each day, everyone can make a mistake, they say. Have you guys been helping out in the kitchen? I know I saw Team Bowler in the kitchen. And they say, don't worry about a thing. Every little thing is gonna be all right. Lie down this evening, wave to the setting sun. Three little birds nest in the treetops. Humming soft rhymes and lullabies, dreams to keep. Whisper, settle now, sweet child, and sleep. Are you guys gonna sing with me this time? Don't worry about a thing. Every little thing is gonna be all right. Rise up this morning, smile with the rising sun. Three little birds pitch by my doorstep, singing sweet songs of melodies pure and true, saying, this is my message to you. Don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing is gonna be all right. The end.
Great job, thank you. So I see some people in the comments, Mr. Barber specifically was wondering why I wasn't singing. But as I said in the beginning, that's why I called in for reinforcements. You did a great job. And I think this book was especially appropriate, wouldn't you say, you know, considering everybody's going through, it's a great message to send to the young people right now.
Absolutely, absolutely.
So thank you for joining us. Before you go, can you talk to them a little bit? I pinned your website onto the chat, but if you want to share any projects that you're working on or anything else that you want to let our followers know.
Yes. As I said before, I have a single out now. It's called Games. The link to the song, the video, any digital platform that you may be listening on, the link is in my bio. I have singles that I released before that. You can also connect to that through my bio. Songs called Better, another song called Bad Habits. Games was actually filmed at the Lyric Theater, so you guys might look familiar to you when you watch the video. Thank you. Filmed there. And yeah,
shout out to your executive producer over there in the back, H2. I hear you.
Hello.
You hear him. Yeah, making sure it's running smoothly over here.
Absolutely. Thanks so much. So I saw that Mr. Barber wanted to join me. So if we can sign off with you, if he still wants to send that request, thank you so much. You guys continue to be safe. Thank you. Take care. Mr. Barber, you still want to join before we sign off? Let me see. Okay, so in addition to the book that Nia read, just a reminder, you have to request. You have to send a request to join. Scroll up to the top. It should give you the option. Scroll up to the top of the chat. It should give you the option to request to join. But here's the first book that I read again, in case any of you, all right. In case any of you would like to grab it. And we're just, before we sign off, we're going to go ahead and have a word from Mr. Barber.
Good morning, good morning, good morning. I just want to say Kamila had done an excellent job. Thank you, Nia Devine and H2, for coming on. This program here is very important. And I'm just superly impressed. It's backwards. She says backwards. Is it backwards? Well, Am I back on?
The title of the book. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah, we're dealing with this, with the stories and the flipping of the screen. Since separated in the sense we're doing our own recording. So the only way we can record is from the front camera. Thank you, Nia Devine. Thank you, H2. Thank you, Kamila, for putting together such a great program. I'm going to ask everyone that is on. This is our Safer at Home virtual series. I saw Nia Devine outside with a beautiful backdrop, and my backdrop don't compare with my wooden fence. But we want you to invite your to share this moment with your children. My daughter was watching it. She ran inside now. But we want everyone to share this with your children, to be a part of this. This is one of our series that we do. Safer at Home. It's a Saturday morning, a beautiful Saturday morning down here where I'm at. But I just want to say thank you. Thank you to Rudy Ruder Rude for watching, and everyone else that has been on. We're doing this daily, Monday through Saturday. We're having an event. I'm really thinking about starting something on Sunday that speaks to honoring those persons that, and talking about those persons that helped the Black Archives get off its feet. The different board members that have come along, those that are with us and those that are going on to the other side. So there's so many things that we're doing the Safer at Home series. We appreciate you. We appreciate you, Kamila. I appreciate my staff for what you guys are doing to keep the Black Archives functioning and keep the Black Archives moving forward. So awesome. That is my favorite song. I would have sung it if you would have brought me on. You know what I'm saying? What is it? Don't worry about a thing. Every little thing's going to be all right. Yeah, I loved it. Yeah, so thank you so much, Kamila. Thank you from where you are. Give a shout out to Maisha, who sent out the reminder. Last week I got so busy on Saturday and I forgot to get on with everyone, but I made major effort to make sure I don't miss this one this Saturday. And I want to thank Jocelyn Hurtado. I want to thank Alicia Melton. I want to thank Lewis Burthen. I want to thank Tito and Isaac, who was my cameraman yesterday, and also want to thank Anjaya Flag, my staff. I want to thank Pat Brainin for supporting us, our board member that is always on. We appreciate you, Ms. Brainin. It's her birthday this weekend, so everybody please say happy birthday to our board chair, Mrs. Patricia Brainin, Jay Brainin. So she always got to say Patricia Jennings Brainin to show the legacy. So we want to say happy birthday to her. We want to say happy, honor everyone. So thank you so much for everything that you guys are doing. And yes. I really appreciate everybody staying safe so we can get through the matter at hand. Thank you. I don't know how to get off screen and give it back to you, Kamila. You can eject me or whatever you need to do to go ahead and say your goodbyes.
So I'll be sending out extra reminders this week because next week will be a special time in the afternoon at 2 p.m. So hopefully you can log on at 2 p.m. and check out Stitches, who's going to be my guest reader. And if you can't come on at 2 p.m., we will be reposting it in the story. So thank you guys. Bye, Robbie. Bye, Shakur. You guys have a great day and remember to stay safer at home.